Hello, fans. Welcome to This MK Life's Get Ready With Me Valentine's Day edition. I'm doing the chocolate rose color look. I already have a light foundation called the Mary Kay CC Cream. It is a complexion corrector that it has SPF to protect me from the sun and help diminish blemishes from my face. I have already done my eyebrows with the eyebrow kit. I have the volumizing tint. I outline with the pencil and then fill in with the tint. I already started with my concealer. It is a deep beige color. I go underneath my eye, and since I have dark circles, I do go on the top of my eye as well. It may look messy now, but I'll go back over it with my sponge. Again, I start on this side. I like to go under the eyebrows so that way I can highlight and define my eyebrows. I also like to go over the top so my eyebrows really stand out. Then I take my sponge and go over what I did, using the tip of the sponge to go out and over and draw that line and smooth it out under my eyebrows, and then going across the top of my lid and underneath. Now I'm going to use my powder foundation brush to use the silky setting powder in the deep beige to go over the concealer to set it, and then also go with the silk setting powder all over my face. I want to blend those lines together so that way you can't tell the difference between the concealer and the foundation. I want to minimize how my nose looks, so I use the concealer left on my sponge and do a stripe down the center of my nose. The foundation's on the side, and I take that powder brush to go all over. It's not a full contour though. Next, I'm using the Espresso Mineral Eyeshadow Powder, and I'll be using the Sunlit Rose and the Rose Gold. With the all-over brush, I have the espresso. I don't want to go past my eyebrow on my eyelid. I start on the edge and start coming forward, and then I make a line across my brow bone, and I meet one-third of the eye on the edge, and then I do the other side. Look at both of your eyes to see if they have the same amount of product, and then reapply eyeshadow as needed. Now I want to move using my blending brush, and I'm going to the next lightest shade, which is the Sunlit Rose, and I'll use that in the middle, meeting the espresso on the corners. See how pigmented that is? Next, I'll use my smudger brush to apply the rose gold, and I'll start from the center of my eye and meet toward the middle. Using a shimmer eyeshadow really gives your eyes a pop. If you want to add more pop, you can add a little bit to your eye ducts. Just don't get it in your eyes, but they make your eyes really stand out. Then take your blending brush and blend the lines together for a full natural look. Again, if you can tell on your eyes one eye has more product than the other, then reapply more product. Now it's time to apply the Fanorama mascara. It's going to give me more volume, it's going to lengthen, and it's going to fan out your lashes, almost giving you that false lash appearance. I usually do two coats and apply top and bottom of my lashes. Just wait and see. I'll let it dry a little bit. I'll move on to my blush before I do my second coat. The blush I'm using is Wineberry. I start at the ball of my cheek and go back toward the top of my ear, dapping and applying and going in circle motions. Now, let's move back to the second application of the mascara. And again, this is the Fanorama mascara. Instead of using a lip liner, I'm going to use the Espresso Matte Liquid Lipstick to do the outline of my lips. If I run out on the brush, I just reapply. And again, just doing the outline. I'll I'll do two colors on the inside and you let me know which one looks better. I press my lips together. I'll touch up the outside later. This is the older pink color. It comes as a set in pink and red. But it's a gel lipstick. It's a hot pink fuchsia. Check that out. I love it. If you go outside of the lines, use your sponge with concealer to correct any mistakes. Using the oil-free makeup remover, I removed it so I can try the next color. I'm using the Espresso Liquid Matte Lipstick to do the outline again. And this time, we're going to go in the middle with a Ballerina Pink Lip Gloss. Again, this is our Chocolate Rose color look. Look at that Ballerina Pink. Wow, I think I like that better. So you can use the hot pink or the Ballerina Pink, depending on your mood. You can reapply the chocolate as needed. And again, touch up with the concealer on your sponge if you go outside of the lines. Next, I want to cover those eyeshadow areas that dripped below my eyelashes. Taking the sponge again, going around my lip area, and then cleaning up under my eyes to give that sharp edge look on my eyeshadow. Now I want to do a highlight on my cheekbones, the same rose